fit. My mom's gonna hate this outfit. She's gonna hate the boots with the skirt. I'm sorry, mother. I'm gonna see if I can show you my hair. I do have these cute little novelty pins in there, but they've sort of blended in. Anyway, the thrill of having my own little hostel slash hotel room to myself. Very executive, very, you know, 29-year-old energy. So there you go. There's always something new to bring you joy in the adult realm. Okay, this is the look. I think that I have made progress in the area of self-love because I actually don't feel that different with makeup on than I do without it. I feel like I'm just like, oh, that's a person, versus like, oh, thank goodness I can be perceived by humanity. So we love to see it. But that also might just be because I'm not as good at doing my makeup as I used to be. Like, I was doing my makeup and I was fully thinking, is this the right way, still the right way to do your makeup? Like, and this is not me having like a, oh, I'm not like other girls. Like, oh my gosh, sometimes I eat pizza. I don't even wear makeup. That's not what I'm doing. This is me being like, wow, I am getting to the age where I'm out of touch. This is what I'm trying to express here. I was literally like, are we doing a winged eyeliner? Is that what the kids are doing now? What are they doing with their eyeliner? What are my brows supposed to look like? Probably not this, but this is the best I could do. And with the eyeshadow, I was like, is this still the method? Do we still do the dark color in the crease and then the light color on the inside of the eye, on the lightest color of all, on the brow bone? What's happening? I know that I could Google it. I know I could watch a makeup tutorial on the YouTube, but it was such a strange feeling. I never thought being out of touch would start at the age of 25. Also, how fun is this? I have just made a huge mess and I don't have to do anything about it because I'm the only person that uses this sink. Glory. If I don't have boba tea every single day by 3, then I feel like I might do something bad. Okay, you can't see me in this video, but I just think it's really important that the world know that I was strutting around with a triangle of brie in one hand and a baguette in the other, feeling my fantasy, walking like I was on the catwalk, and I've never been happier.
What does it mean if I fully do not remember this?
Okay, intellectually, I understand that that was Arthur's seat, and yes, I do remember climbing the mountain itself, but I have no memory of this incredible view, and that was very distressing to me because that seems like the kind of thing that one would remember. All I ever needed was the music and the mirror and the chance to dance for you. I found shelter under a tiny piece of architecture. Stumbled across one of the pubs we had eaten at, then went to another bubble tea establishment, but resisted the impulse to get two boba teas in one day, and instead got a caramel gatto and a latte. Not only did I go to imbibe my refreshments in Prince's Street Gardens like in days of yore, but I found the exact spot where we had sat and eaten our little cakes looking up at the castle all those years ago. I remember really purposefully treasuring up that moment in my heart. I had been a sad, lonely lady for many months, and under the changing autumn trees, with new friends around me, I felt happy again for the first time in a long while.
I sit before you now, having returned to the gardens, a lady who is only sad and lonely sometimes, and has embraced these emotions, along with joy and contentment, and also having built over the years a killer 9.5 hour playlist for feeling despair to the full, which I listen to far less these days than I used to.
Ah, the beautiful city.
Did you know that you can be an elegant lady about town in your lovely dress from a consignment store, in your little hotel room? All of this is possible for him who believes.
Vegetable. So when I was here before, there is a market on the Royal Mile in a old converted church, and lo, I found the market. And last time I was here, I got one of these sketches by the same artist of Victoria Street. And so there they were, all the lovely many drawings. And so I got another one, except last time, long, long ago, they only cost £8. And now, inflation, am I right?
How did you know that you had to let go? Saw that you thought much too late. You went out late and came in too soon. Didn't have time to turn back the moon. And you feel so sad that somebody cares.
Is the fit of the day. Don't look at the rain jacket. Let's pretend we don't have to be practical. And what's this on the foot? Of course, the boot. And then this is my makeup. My hair is still wet. Everyone has their own journey. I have opted for a lip, which I've not worn in many a month. I like this one better. I didn't put on eyeliner. My eyeshadow is lighter. I'm excited. Ooh, and then my earrings and my beautiful neck wash and the scrunchie I'm only wearing because I accidentally wore it into the shower and it's damp and I don't want it to foistle all of my other belongings. Now I'm gonna go get a donut from a place that my friend Kenzie recommended.
Just lost my mind in the donut shop and bought 3 donuts.
And eat it in a charming location. It was supposed to rain today and it's not raining yet, so I feel like I need to get out there as soon as possible before something terrible happens.
Allow me to show you this orange posset donut, and I think you will understand why I completely lost control of my senses in the bakery. During a break in the rain, I made a run for it and hit up some shops in the iconic W Bow of Victoria Street, including this Harry Potter-themed shop because I'm a Harry Potter adult, and to further prove my point, I went to this graveyard that Miss J.K. used to walk around and from whence she got inspiration for the names Tom Riddle and Minerva McGonagall. Then I met a fake dog.
Hello.
Then I met a real dog. Then I took a pic of the cafe where she wrote Sorcerer's Stone, but it suffered a terrible fire and is closed for reno. Then I went to the National Museum of Scotland, whither are displayed the taxidermied remains of Dolly the Sheep and also a killer fashion exhibit. Okay, ever since we went to go see the Withered Hand of St. Stephen in Budapest, I have been hooked on adoring holy relics, and so I heard tell of a certain church where I could go see a certain shoulder bone of a certain St. Andrew, and let me tell you, what a treat. This is my Boba manifesto. I'm gonna have bubble tea every day. The ideal tea room will hit you with a wave of warmth when you walk in the door. Perhaps it will be too warm, but given the likelihood of it being a chill, damp day from which you have escaped, the heat blast, though a little close since you are already feeling humidified, will be very welcome. There should also be so much decorative paraphernalia on the walls that you cannot lean about without fear of 1,000 antique plates crashing down on you. This is the modern equivalent of a corset. The very walls keep you from slouchery and slumpage. Mismatched china in interesting patterns is a must. It is the adult version of a Happy Meal toy. You are surprised and delighted by what you get, or you compare it to your friends and cry because you like hers better. Maybe you can swap. The food, and I always forget this part, will be average unless it is a scone with clotted cream, which will rock your world. But at the end of the day, you are not here for the food. You are here, in this Victorian Cracker Barrel parallel, for the same reason you make all your pursuits and decisions. You are simply here for the vibes.
So don't.